Just for the records, I'm just giving the question again. There's a wedge of capital M mass and there's a small block on that of small m. The wedge angle of inclination is theta. All surfaces, all contact surfaces, whatever you see are frictionless. And then there is a force acting on the capital mass such that the capital mass alone is accelerating with capital A. And the acceleration is so much so that this guy, the small m, starts moving up with respect to the wedge, starts moving up. So if it is moving, it has started moving up at any given point. If it has started, that means it is accelerating up and it will gain velocity. It's not like it will reduce. Whatever motion is happening at one instance, that motion will get aggravated further and it is increasing in velocity. And when it has moved up x with respect to the wedge, so I can put some points on the wedge from here to here is x. Then how much is the velocity is the question. Is that question clear? So I just made a mass in a bus and the bus was accelerating with A. I asked how much is the force with respect to ground? Nothing. Force with respect to the bus. Like with respect to somebody who's standing in the bus. Okay, or with respect to the same guy because he's in the bus, like this box with respect to itself or whatever. What is the force on the body? Then as a mathematical solution, mind you, as a mathematical solution, we say that, okay, let me study in the frame of the bus. Frame of the bus means as if the bus is not moving. So what appears in the frame? That the block was here, now the block is here, right? Get the point? It is actually the bus has accelerated with A, but you are feeling that, okay, this is not moving. Then the distance covered per unit time, you will feel that this guy is covering the same distance per unit time, right? So it will feel like this is accelerating back with A or not. Is that clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Is that clear or not? Everybody? Ask me right now.
It's clear, sir.
Everybody, it's clear. Okay. Now, if somebody in the bus feels like, I think I've given you 4 or 5 videos with this kind of thing, right? Go through those videos. If somebody in the bus feels like this guy is moving with A acceleration backwards, this mass small m is moving with A acceleration backwards, then he will associate a force to it, right? Right? It was a false movement, so the force associated is also a false force. Get the point? What force can create a capital A acceleration on a small m mass? What force can create a capital A acceleration on a small m mass? Yes, nobody.
Pseudo force backwards.
A force equal to m capital A or not?
Yeah.
This much of force will create a capital A acceleration on a small m mass, right? Right? So this is the force with respect to the frame of the bus. It is not an existent force, so they call it as fictitious force or pseudo force. Get the point? It's called a pseudo force. Get the point? Quite handy in solving things because sometimes when a lot of things are moving like this, this wedge will be moving that side and this will be going up, you might not be able to comprehend in the actual frame. Okay. So the question what Ananya asked, thankfully the final velocity was also asked in the frame of the sphere. Initial in the frame of the sphere, finally also in the frame of the sphere. So you can solve the whole question in the frame of sphere. It becomes a beyond the ITJE advanced question if they would have asked the velocity not in the frame of the sphere. Generally, you should be able to do, but in the exam, they'll not ask that because it will consume some time. Okay. But they asked a very simple thing in the frame of the sphere again. So what you have to do is you have to make the sphere as your world. So we'll make this wedge as our world. Okay, and put all the forces on the body which are there. Is that clear? So if I made this wedge as a world, that means I am talking in the reference frame of a wedge, which is accelerating. So it is called a non-inertial frame. Okay. Get the point? If the wedge is accelerating, the frame is called a non-inertial frame. Okay. How did the word coin up? You go and just Google it. Okay. So what are the forces? All the forces which were there in the inertial frame will be there, plus the pseudo force. Is that clear? So what are the forces? What are the forces which were there? One was mg. Nobody can stop that, right? Then it is touching something that will give a normal reaction. Can't do a thing about it. Okay. It may be as low as zero if it is just touching, but it is touching with, it is actually pressing it. So good normal reaction. Okay, let me ask you something. This normal reaction would be more than mg cos theta or less or equal to in this particular case. Somebody answers me with a sense of physics, I'll be quite happy. Mg compare it to equal to greater than or less than mg cos theta. Fast.
It's
greater than.
Okay, I'll leave you today at 9 p.m. Okay, I'm sorry. 9 p.m. Yeah, tell me.
N is greater than mg cos theta.
Who says that? Who is that?
Amod.
Amod. Why, Mr. Amod?
Because mg cos theta was balancing it before only, when there was no force. So now that you add a force, it will be greater than mg cos theta.
Okay, correct. But like with a sense of physics, yeah, absolutely right. I mean, you might have got it with the sense of physics itself.
So when we bring the slope to a rest, we apply a relative acceleration backward on the mass. So when you take its component, our mass.
No. Don't add another story to it that I'm going to stop it and all. Okay. Check it. Amoda said the right thing. Greater than mg cos theta. Okay. When you accelerate the wedge this way, this will be pressed back even more. Get the point? In the class, what I do is I take a cardboard and I take a duster or something. I move the cardboard this way very fast. The duster doesn't slip down. Reason? Shall I do it over here? My pass hai. Oh.
The static friction is overcome.
The reason is what? The reason is that the normal reaction between the two, when this was the cardboard and I keep a duster beside it, what is the normal reaction? Nothing. N is equal to zero. It may have lot of mu, but what's the use of a mu when N is nothing? The duster is going to slip down for sure. Get the point? Is that clear? But when I move the cardboard this side with some acceleration, mind you, not velocity, but acceleration, it has to be an increasing velocity. When I move with the acceleration that side, what happens? This guy gets pressed against that. Okay, you may say a pseudo force of that much is acting on it or whatever. It gets pressed against the cardboard. Is that clear? And that pressing force is the normal reaction. So normal reaction develops. And mu times n may take care of the mg, the weight mg, the mu times n can take care, and maybe it is not falling down. Is that clear? Right? Get the point?
Yeah.
Okay. So when I'm accelerating it forward, this is like pressed back. Get the point? When I used to go to school, no, I used to climb on the bus at the back. At the back of the bus, there used to be a ladder. Okay. I related with pseudo force so much with this, you won't imagine. Okay. I could not get a very good feeling. I related with this. When I am on the bus and on the ladder, when this guy started the bus, when the bus was started, I was like big time, like blown back, big time blown back. Somehow I could just hold on to the bus. Get the point? So the bus started forward with A. I received a pseudo force backward with my mass times A. Get the point? Because my body wanted to remain at rest what it was and did not want to move forward. Is that clear? I did not actually got a force. The actual force what I got is on my hand, and if my leg is like I'm locking my leg with something, or at least my hand got an actual force forward only, no pseudo force and all. But it felt to me as if I'm thrown back badly. That is how I used to imagine pseudo force. Yaar, ye to ekdam hi real force lagta hai. Are you getting the point? Is that clear? Is that clear? No.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. अभी भी आप लोग तो कार में आते हैं. If you sit in the car and the dad starts your car, you will feel a force backwards pressing you on the seat. Okay, while he has started. Later on, he goes for a constant velocity, no force. He is slowing down. Then maybe the force is forward. You are going thrown forward. Okay. So one is this force. One is that force. And since I am studying with respect to this mass, I will put a extra force. Which way? If this was this way, exactly ulta way. Okay. I don't care the incline is this way or that way, whatever. If the mass was accelerating horizontal, I'll get a horizontal backward force. Okay. And that would be the small body's mass. I'll say it as my mass into the big guy's acceleration. It's a very crappy thing. Okay. It is not actual force, so it looks like crap. This mass and somebody else's acceleration. Get the point? Is that clear? Now, when you introduce this force, then you can say that this block is stationary and these are the forces acting. Okay. And whatever you will find out will be with respect to that. Kinetic energy also with respect to that. Okay. So kinetic energy of a body with respect to something else is again a very deep thing, and I used to have a very deep thinking on it. Like if somebody is in space, he is moving at 2 meters per second with respect to the other guy because nobody knows who is moving. Then what is the kinetic energy of one? So one is zero with respect to the other one. It is all with respect to. So is kinetic energy with respect to something else is a valid thing or not a valid thing? I used to just keep on thinking and break my head. Okay. Never ever I got an answer for that. Now, what was I saying? So you are doing with respect to this, and these are the forces. Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me so this mass doesn't matter. So the story is there is a normal force like this. There is mg, which I'll break in two parts. What is that? Mg sine theta and mg cos theta. There was a force in this line. What was that? Small m into capital A, which again I'll break in two parts, which is small m capital A cos theta, because this angle is theta, and small m capital A sine theta. Get the point? And somebody said that n will be more than mg cos theta because this will also be pressing it back, and this plus this might be n. Okay, but I'm not discussing that right now. Okay. Now in this direction, these are the forces. It travels x distance with respect to the wedge. What would be the velocity? Now it is up to me. Should I do a force and velocity thing? Shall I do by kinematics or shall I do by what do you say? Energy, right? Get the point? So let me do with both. Somebody tell me with energy. What is the work energy theorem? How much ever work is done on the body, the energy goes up by that much, right? Right? So what is the work done on the body? If it goes x distance, what is the work done on the body? Work done on the body is change in total energy, right? Any doubt? Ayo. Nobody's there.
So is it force into displacement? So you can just
What is that? I'm little
theta.
Surprised right now. Why people are taking time in saying, if I say F1 force is here, F2 force is here, and ultimately the body moved x distance there, what is the work done on the body?
F1 minus F2 into x, right?
Yes, sir. Or to be like very, very like, I have to be very honest with each work, then F1x is the work done by this force minus F2x is the work done by the other force. Get the point? And what happens to the work done? It changes the energy of the body, right? Right? Sometimes the work done by gravity is included as opposite of potential energy. Then this total energy, when you write with potential energy, then you don't take the work done by gravity. If you write the total energy only as kinetic energy, very important thing I'm telling you right now, then you take work done of gravity also. Get the point? It is up to you. Mechanics is mechanics. Get the point? Like gravitational force is no special force which will do any special things. Only a special name to the work done by gravity, which is opposite of PE minus of potential energy. Is that clear? So when I write this, in the work done, you include the things done by gravitational force or not is up to you. Okay. Somebody please tell me. Yeah, somebody was saying, right? Tell me.
Yeah, will it be cos theta into x?
What?
The work done by that force.
What are you saying? Loudly, man, I can't hear you.
Will the work done by that force be ma cos theta into x?
With what force? Work done by this force?
Yeah.
Yeah, only that you want to say. Okay, I'll write that.
Oh, if it's like total, you do ma cos theta minus mg sin theta.
Ma cos theta minus mg sin theta into x is the work done or not?
Yeah.
Right? Will be the change in energy. So suppose it has become v velocity from zero velocity, then what is the change in energy?
Half mv square.
And would you add like the height got changed, so mgh also? I'm not writing mgh. Ask me why.
No. Why?
Ask me why.
Why?
Okay. Because I took the work done by gravitational force, right? What did I tell you right now? If you don't take the work done by gravitational force, then the total energy you can call as kinetic energy plus potential energy, right? Let me do that also. Let me do that and write. If I do that and write, then the work done is what? Work done is only ma cos theta into x is the work done by this, right?
Yes, sir.
Right? Because gravitational force, work done by that, I've given a special name. So I'll do that special name. So total kinetic energy is changes half m v square plus change in potential energy. How much is the change in potential energy? This work done must have increased the kinetic energy and the potential energy. How much is the increase in potential energy? MgH. How much is the H? How much is this H?
X sine theta.
This H is how much? It is equal to X sine theta or not? The triangle formed over there, this is X, that is theta. So this is X sine theta or not? Right?
Yes, sir.
So I'll write it as mgh sine theta. sorry, x mg x sin theta. Is this equation different from that one?
No,
it's the same, right? Sometimes people mess it up by writing mg h also and this also. Hence, such a big warning to you guys. So note it down in your head. If you note it in the notebook, that page is going to go anywhere. Okay, memorize. If you include the work done by, I'm telling you, these are important things. I'm telling you, nobody told me, and hence it became a big problem for oneself to solve. So what I thought over for say days, I'm telling you in minutes. Okay. And some of you are very smart, so you don't have to be told. I know that, but I was not that smart. So the thing is, note it in your head. If the work done by forces due to gravity, whether a component of gravity or the whole thing, if you are including that, then in the total energy, you don't have anything called potential energy. Is that clear? If you are excluding in the work energy theorem, if you are excluding the work done by gravity, then in the total energy, you add potential energy. Okay. Sometimes this is the safer thing to do. Okay. Is that clear? Now, what's the answer? Question solved. You have to write this line. Physics, the beauty of physics is you write a line and question solved. I ask the velocity, this is the velocity. Take the two up, MMH gets cancelled, question solved. Is that clear, Ananya?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Meaning to say that you have to do a lot of thinking while making the diagram and making the forces. But once you write a line, no, that is almost the solution of it. Now, suppose I had done my kinematics as the first, second chapter, and I have a lot of confidence there. And in potential energy and all, I don't have confidence. Then what I'll say is this body is having a certain acceleration. How much is the acceleration? This much force up, this much force down. How much is the acceleration? Acceleration is A cos theta minus G sine theta, right? How did I get that? The net force, which was M A cos theta minus M G sine theta is equal to net force must be the force into mass into acceleration of the body or not, right? M gets cancelled and you get that, right? Is the theta changing? No. Is A changing? No, they said it is going with a constant A. Is G changing? No, my earth is behaving like a constant mass. Okay, it's not changing. Nothing is changing, so it's a constant acceleration. So I'll jump on to this equation. V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. This was valid for constant acceleration. And I love this equation because we have been doing it from class 9 onwards. So if you put this, are you going to get the right answer? Yes, why not? Let's see. V square is equal to U is 0. 2, how much is that A? A is so much, right? A cos theta minus G sin theta into S. S is the distance it has gone. How much is the distance gone? X, right? Is this answer any different from this answer or that answer? No, it is not. The 2 goes up, it's the same thing, right? You have to write one line only here also, by the way. But work energy theorem is preferred. It's also a lot of, like here it had to be a constant acceleration, then only I can write that. Get the point?
I have a question.
I mean, theta not, I mean, udhar bhi extra kaam karna padta, but a lot of cases here is like in the next case, this would be an easy one than the other one. I'll do the other one also both ways. Any doubt in this?
So here the V and the A will all be relative to the...
Yes. All with respect to this. That's the crappy thing in the question. If they had asked what is the kinetic energy with respect to the ground or what is the velocity with respect to the ground becomes a good question. And that I'll do when I'm taking class, that I'll do with respect to the ground. Okay. It's a cheap question. So that becomes a good question which can come in JE. The previous question, it becomes a very, very good question and man might not even come in JE when they ask with respect to the ground. But they ask with respect to this mass M, and I'm happily introduced this force. Ek pseudo force dala, bola thank God. Sab iske hisab se karna hai ki bas ek extra force tha. One imaginary force was there extra and just get done with it. Are you getting the point? You ask me fast.
So, but if you take in consideration only like real forces,
yeah,
then there is no, Yeah, so then there is no force acting on it in the, like, up the slope direction, right?
No, not at all.
So won't it go only up or down?
What, up
with
or
respect?
Down?
So if the only forces acting on it are N and mg plus F, then then the only force acting on it are in the, like, upward direction and then to the left.
I could not understand. I mean, if the only forces acting are, let me change the pen. Put a light pen. Ek N or ek MG. Yeah. Then what are you saying?
So then how is it going, like, in that direction? Up,
which direction?
Up the slope. Up the slope.
Who said? Who said it is going up the slope? What is this? When you say how is it going there, then it must be going there, no?
Okay.
Where is it going? The block is somewhere over here after some time.
Yeah, so it just, so
the block is here, right? After some time, right?
Yeah.
And initially the guy was here, now the guy is here, right?
Yeah.
Or maybe here, whatever. So it has gone somewhere there, no? Like this.
Yeah.
It all depends, like, what it is, I'll solve it. I said no, we'll solve it. It's a good question with respect to everything.
So with respect to the ground,
everything. You do it yourself, and it is among one of my, in the chain of videos, solving through problems. I don't know. I've unrestricted it or not. We have done this. Okay, anyways, I'm sticking to the question now. Okay, if it was that and that, I'm not doing. Anything with respect to what I said as a doubt? Okay, so let me just summarize it. Ananya, in summary, what has happened? In summary, I put the forces on it with the reference frame of this. I put all the forces valid. Okay.
Yes.
Then I saw that it is moving x distance. In that frame, it is moving x distance. In the actual frame, you saw that this guy was asking and it is moving somewhere else altogether. Okay. So forget it. It's an easy question. In that frame, it is going x distance. So I said, what is the work done by the forces for that x distance? And that work done in the forces must be the change in energy. I wrote an equation for that. I got the work done. I said it is a change in energy. Get the point? And then that is it. That was the answer. Get the point? Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
The other way, what I just said is, if these are the forces, I made the forces. If these are the forces and it is going that way in that frame, then what is the acceleration that way? I got the acceleration and connected the acceleration with velocity with one of the equations what I know, right? V square is equal to u square plus 2as, and it gave me the answer. Mind you, this connection is only possible when acceleration came as constant. So the acceleration which came, thankfully, came as constant over here. It came as a cos theta minus g sine theta, and thankfully it was a constant. So I did that also. Is that clear what we did? Because I'm going to do the same thing for the next one. Same thing, nothing else. Is that clear?
Okay, sir. Thank you.
अभी थैंक यू नहीं, अभी खत्म नहीं है, अभी नेक्स्ट वन करना है मेरे को. तुम्हारा क्वेश्चन, आई हैव टू डू इट.
सर इट्स द सेम एप्लीकेशन आई अंडरस्टूड इट.
यू विल बी एबल टू डू, नो?
यस सर.
देन यू टेल मी, आई विल नॉट लीव यू लाइक दैट. फंस गए बच्चे. इज द मास एम. Now, does the mass of the big thing matter? No. It is accelerating this way with A, right? So what we'll say, it is accelerating back with respect to this, it is going back with, tell me. This one is having a force backwards with how much? A pseudo force of MA backwards, right? On the body, right? Right, Ananya?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So after some time, the body is at some angle theta. From here to there it went, okay? It was here and it went there. And the angle it went is theta. Get the point? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So we cannot take the starting, we cannot take the end situation, we take any middle situation. Okay, that's a very important thing. We take a situation anywhere, not like right in the middle, anywhere here, and analyze the forces. Guys, everybody pay attention. If you take here also and there also, you might get the answer, but for any worthwhile question, you'll have to go in a random situation and analyze the forces. Okay. So can you tell me the forces, Ananya or anybody? Can you tell me the forces?
MG, normal reaction. The pseudo force.
Okay. I'll not mess up the diagram. That's the body. It has got a MG down, right?
Yeah.
It has got a normal reaction along this or not? Along the normal, right?
Yeah.
Right. And what else?
The pseudo force.
A pseudo force this way, right? Right? Chalo, MG down. Right? Now this is a slope, a varying slope in the point. Say this angle was, I'll put it in green. Say this angle was alpha. Can you tell me the forces on it? Can you tell me the forces on it? Fast, fast, fast.
MG cos alpha.
Yeah, tell me what?
So along the, you're telling along the line, right?
Along this tangent. Yeah.
Along the tangent. Okay, wait. So let me do.
Yeah, tell me. What are the forces? There also we did the same thing, no, in the previous question. Along the length it is moving. Okay, how much length it has moved? R theta length it has moved. Okay, along that. What is the force?
It's mg sine theta and...
Not theta. There it is at alpha angle.
Alpha, how theta okay. Came. Mg sine alpha.
Sine or cos? Sine or cos?
For mg it's sine.
Everybody agrees?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, this is alpha, so this tiny angle will be alpha, right? Alternate, right? So this angle over here will be how much? 90 minus alpha. So mg cos of 90 minus alpha means mg sine alpha. So I'll put that mg sine alpha. Yeah, what else?
Me sine alpha.
What?
Sine alpha.
Now this is 90 minus alpha, so this angle will be alpha itself, right? This is totally 90 degree, right?
Yes, sir.
So this you said is 90 minus alpha. So this must be alpha, right?
Yes, sir.
So MA cos alpha, right? Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So you got two forces this way. That's it. We got the forces. We don't want to do anything else right now. Now, can you tell me that if I say acceleration and distance relation, can I do that? I'm just making a big deal of a very small question. Answer is like a two line thing. I'll write it over here. V square is equal to u square plus 2as. Can I do that? U is given to me zero. V is what is asked. And A will be so much by M, right? Shall I do? And is that the answer?
Yes, so won't acceleration keep changing as the body is going around? Like alpha is different. No?
Absolutely right. The point is we cannot apply this. Why? Alpha changes, right? Here alpha was zero. So acceleration along this mg had no component, mg sine zero was nothing, and ma cos alpha was ma totally because it was totally left side, right? So this keeps on changing, so it becomes a mess. We can't apply this. And this formula we got, I hope you remember from a v dv by dx integration. When a is constant and when you integrate this, what do you get? A dx v dv integrated. What do you get when a is constant? I've taken it out of the integration. You get ax this side and you get this side as v square by 2 going from u to v, then putting the limits v square by 2 minus u square by 2. Put the 2 on that side and we get that. Clearly when a was constant. So can you tell me if I have to apply the kinematics approach? Since kinematics you have done at J level, what is the equation? I will never apply kinematics for this for sure, but I just want to ask you that had I applied kinematics, what would be the relation we'll write?
So can you do like relative motion of the block with respect to the center?
Respect to the center, meaning to say we are already doing with respect to the sphere.
Yeah. So
now like, any respect you want to give to which all things?
No, you just say that its acceleration will be a g backwards and g downwards.
A backwards g downwards, right?
Yeah, and a is...
Yeah, so it is this so much along the tangent.
Yeah.
Okay, along the tangent.
Yeah.
You want to do it in two different pieces. No, I'm just wanting to complicate a bit. Okay, so that when a complicated question comes, you're not scared of that. What is the acceleration along this? Acceleration along this is net force along the tangent, which is ma cos alpha plus mg sine alpha. That's the net force along the tangent is equal to mass into acceleration along the tangent. Okay, so let me call it as a dash. Okay, so you get your a dash is equal to a cos alpha plus g sine alpha. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now we can't apply that v square is equal to u square, but we want to know v, so we can very well apply what is the basic. Basic is v dv by dx is equal to a cos alpha plus g sine alpha. Why the hell we are doing like this? Why not an easy way? Because we are learning to do some difficult questions when they come by. Okay, so you rather pay attention over here. Is that clear? What is varying? Alpha is varying, and hence a problem in doing integration, because we have got three things: dv, dx, and alpha. We want a d alpha also, so that we can do away with dx. So what is this dx actually? Dx is along the tangent. I'm going very fast now. Okay. How much little distance you moved? How is it related to that alpha or all? Alpha and all. So alpha radian was the total angle, and this is d alpha. D alpha is the extra angle on the total angle. So how is dx and d alpha related?
D alpha is
dx.
R d alpha, right? Radius times the angle is your arc length or not, right? So we can write that over here and take it on the other side. So what we get is v dv is equal to a cos alpha plus g sine alpha, and then what? R d alpha. I'll write R over here and d alpha over here. Is that clear? Now it is something which can be integrated. So we'll jump on to do the integration. We do the integration. V is going from where to where? Integration means you are taking care of each and every point from there to there. You just tell the integrator that, boss, it's the same equation, but alpha is going from here to there. Where to where? 0 to theta. V is going from where to where? 0 to V. Initially, they gave 0. If they gave something else, you can write that. So what does this side give me? V square by 2 minus 0 square by 2, obviously. And what will this side give me? Remember, A cos alpha integration. Cos alpha integration will be what? Cos alpha integration, guys?
Minus
sine alpha, right? And sine theta into sine alpha integration?
Cos. It'll just be cos.
Plus g cos alpha, right? Limits going from where to where? 0 to theta, right? So first I'll put theta in this. What do I get? I'll write the minus here and the plus here. So what do I get? G cos theta minus a sine theta, right? A big minus, and then what do I put in that? I put zero in that, right? Lower limit, right? When I put zero in sine, what do I get? Zero. Sine zero is zero, right?
Awesome.
Right?
Yes, sir.
And when I put in this, what do I get?
G. G.
You get G. Cos zero is one, right? You get a G, right? Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So don't think that, okay, just upper limit put k sine alpha, sine theta, sine theta and cos theta is the answer. You'll get something like this. Is that clear? I'll not recommend. Why? Because we have the momentum conservation, energy conservation, angular momentum conservation to avoid doing this integration and the actual what is going on bit with our hand. Okay. When there is no option, then we do this. Is that clear? So what's the option over here? The option over here is ask ourselves that what is the work done by these forces? Okay, when it goes from there to there. So work done by gravity force and work done by MA force. Mg was down all the time, right? So instead of doing a Mg sine theta into integration of this curve, it is as good as, again, I can show you the integration, but no time at all. It is as good as work done by Mg is, I'll write it over here, Mg into the displacement along that, right? This much or not? Right? Right, guys?
Yes, sir.
It has gone down. It has gone down by this much. So work done by Mg is, or you can say change in potential energy, you can call it as. So is this much distance, which is R, and this whole angle was theta. So this length is R cos theta. So that tiny length is R minus R cos theta, right? Right? R minus R cos theta. So Mg into R 1 minus cos theta is what? Work done by gravity. Get the point? What's the other force into play? Again, I'll not do an integration along the curve. I know that MA was all the time this way, all the time this way, all the time this way, all the time that way. So it is MA into not this curve distance, but that horizontal distance, how much it moved. Because even if I study the small curve of a dx all the time, then what was this component of the dx? In the integration also, we'll have to integrate that component of the dx, which will eventually mean how much horizontal we moved. That dx, dx, dx integrated is how much horizontal we moved. So how much is that? Again, with this triangle, it comes as R sine theta. So the work done by that A force or the pseudo force would be MA into R sine theta. Is that clear? Is that clear? Mg was down and it moved down. So it's a positive work done by gravity and positive work done by this. So this total, if you add this, this total will be the addition of these two will be the change in kinetic energy, which is half mv square. Right? M gets cancelled all over. 2 goes up there. Get the point? And what do we get? We get v square is equal to la 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 la. Is that clear? Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now you can compare over here. What you are getting? What should be the answer? What is negative of what? What is positive of what? What is the difference in the negative and positive? You can compare this. I'm not writing this and I'm not revealing the small difference and all. Okay. You can do this yourself. But this is the preferred way because time is up actually. You can do it yourself and ask me doubts. So this is the work done. Okay. And obviously, if you would have considered work done by the pseudo force only, then this will be written on that side as loss in potential energy, as a minus of the same term, because the energy potential energy went down so much down. So loss minus of the same term. It's the same thing. Okay. So that's the answer. Okay. Then I think in the problem what you gave, they wrote A is equal to G, right?
Yes, sir.
So you can replace A with a G and that would be the answer. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
I had a very interesting question, man. I could not give. I'll ask that question next time. Yeah. Now. I can't control asking it, but I'll not. There's a spring. Isme collision, collision, sab kara deta main. Mass is equal to zero. Very interesting question. Another mass M falls on it in elastic collision. Okay, whatever height and all, whatever you want to know is given. This was H height. Inelastic collision. Mass zero spring. What is the maximum velocity in its whole travel of going, compressing and going up? What is the Vmax? Is that clear? Is the question clear?
So could you repeat it?
There's a mass M, zero velocity. It is let go, dropped. Okay, when they say dropped, assume velocity is zero. Okay, the word drop, drop from rest. So it hits a spring, a massless spring, which has a K and length and whatever you require is given. Whatever you require for the spring is given. K is there. Okay. It will hit it, compress it, come back and maybe jump back again, right? In the whole process of hitting, compressing and jumping back again, what is the maximum velocity of the body? Is that clear? Is the question clear? Okay, give me in the physics doubt group your answers. Don't give me in individual. The messages just go way, way, way down. Okay?
Anywhere during the journey, Vmax.
Yeah, in the whole journey, goes, compresses, goes back again. In the whole journey, what is Vmax? Okay, how much is the value of Vmax? Is that clear? Is it clear? Is the question clear? Okay,